Hi there, Flight Sim fans. My name's James, I'm the director of TrackHat, and today I've got a really quick video guide for you of getting started with head tracking in Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020 with the TrackHat Sensor V2. Now, Microsoft Flight Simulator is our most popular game and sim, but remember that this video will also apply to lots of other flight games and simulators as well. So a lot of the lessons about using mapping tools and mapping your curves and your outputs and your hotkeys will also apply to other simulators. One of the key things to remember before you get started is that head tracking is a really subjective experience. Everyone has a slightly different setup, different screens and different controls, and as a result, it will take time to tune head tracking to your exact liking. So remember to be patient and follow my advice carefully to get the best experience possible from your head tracking setup. Let's get started. One of the first things you're going to want to do when you start setting up TrackHat OpenTrack is sort out your hotkeys. This is a really important thing to do, as the hotkeys will enable you to interact with head tracking while you're inside the simulator, to pause and center your views to make sure you can always adjust yourself properly and comfortably. Now, in TrackHat OpenTrack, hit the options page and it is the first menu that's open here. The bare minimum you want to set is the center and toggle keys. The center key resets your view, so no matter how you move your head, you know you can always get back into the same position. And the toggle key allows you to pause your head tracking so that you can move your head into a certain position to engage with something, pause it, enable, and then, you know, interact with something, and then unpause it to move your head back to where it was. So I'll give you a demonstration of both now in FS2020. As you can see, I'm looking straight into the simulator right now, but my view is not straight ahead. So if I hit center on my view key, there you go. My head is back to where it was. So if ever I move my head slightly and want to be in this comfortable position again, all I need to do is hit center again and my view will be back to the start. Now, the toggle key is equally important for something like a serious simulator where I want to move my head into a position to interact with something like this. I can pause my view and then move my head comfortably. It's not latched to head tracking right now, so I can use the mouse, for example, right now to interact with my radio stacks and my GPS, and then I can hit it again and I'm free to use head tracking again as I need to. So setting these hotkeys is really, really important for head tracking, and getting comfortable using them will make things much, much easier for you moving forwards. Okay. Up next, let's talk about outputs. Now, it's entirely possible that there are some axes of movement that you may not want to use in the flight simulator or a game. And it's very, very easy to disable outputs or change them to your need. Open up the options tab and hit the second menu here for outputs. As you can see, you have the 6 degrees of movement here. So you've got yaw, pitch, roll, X movement, Y movement, and Z movement. Now, you can set any of these to your liking by changing the source. So if you, for example, want to move your head left and right and have your movement move along the x-axis instead, you can select x-axis here and it will be changed from yaw to x-axis. You probably want to leave these settings as they are by default. In some cases, you might find that you have to invert the view. For example, if you move your head left, the view moves right in the game. All you have to do is tick that invert box there and the axis will be inverted. Very, very simple. Hit OK and go back into your simulator. Up next, let's talk about using in-game keys. There are keys available within the game to change your default position. So if, by example, you find that the centered position in head tracking is too low, too high, or too far to one side, you can use the keyboard keys in Microsoft Flight Simulator to change that default position. So if I go back into simulator right now and unpause head tracking, I think I'm sat a little bit too high. I'm looking up over my controls. I want to be looking at my controls a bit more. If I just hit the down arrow on the keyboard, there you go. The default viewpoint has changed. I'm now sat much more down in the cockpit. The same applies to obviously up and left and right as well. You can move your position to anywhere and then that becomes your new central point for head tracking. As you can see, if I reorient, recenter my view, it will go straight back to that central point. This is a really important thing to do to make sure that your head is always in that most comfortable position for head tracking by default. Make sure you get comfortable with using these keys inside the simulator. Mapping your curves in TrackHat OpenTrack is a fairly tricky thing to do, but it's a really, really important experience to change head tracking to your need. So I'm going to show you how to do that right now. If you press on the mapping tool, you're presented with this graph. Now, along the top of this graph window, you have 6 tabs for each of the individual axes of movement. On these pages, you're allowed to change the graph of movement to either make the input more sensitive or more relaxed, depending on how you like it. Now, when head tracking is active, you can actually see the little dot moving across that axis. And I know, for example, if you look at this graph, that I input 25 degrees of movement in real life results in roughly 90 degrees of movement in the game. Now, if I hop back into the simulator, and if I yaw my head to the left or to the right, you can see that that's about right. 90 degrees either way. I only had to move my head a tiny bit. Now, if that's a bit too sensitive for you, all you have to do is hop into the mapping window for each of the axes that you want to adjust, and then you can drag this top point over to the right. So now I need to move my head 100 degrees either side to get around 180 degrees. So if I hop back into the simulator and unpause head tracking, I have to move my head much, much further to get that full 360 degree field of view. Now, understanding this concept is difficult, but it's really important to make sure you get the most out of your flight simulator. Now, what you can also do on this page is do something called asymmetric mapping. This will allow you to map a different experience to each side of the axis. When you enable it, you tick this box right here. And now, if I set this graph really, really sharp on this one side and hop back into the simulator, you can see that if I turn my head left, I barely have to turn it at all to look all the way behind me. But if I look to the right, I have to move my head quite far. Now, this is a highly, highly customizable experience. Most users probably won't need to use asymmetric mapping, so leaving it deselected is the best. Okay, next let's talk about dead zones. Dead zones are pretty important in mapping. We tend to leave them out of the default configuration so that most users can set their own dead zones by default. A dead zone will allow you a little bit of movement in the middle of your window where your head is sat completely stationary, where head tracking doesn't really react to your movement. This allows for a more relaxed feel to your head tracking, and I'll show you how to set one up right now. In the mapping properties window, you can click on a point on the line to create a new point. Now that point can be dragged up or down to adjust a curve like this to give you a smoother experience. Dragging that point down a little bit will set a more relaxed start to that curve. As you can see, it now ramps up as I turn my head. I'm going to put that to about here and then demonstrate in the simulator. So right now, as you can see, if I move my head a little bit, it's not moving much. But as soon as I go past that point, I only have to move a little bit more to get the full 180 degree field of view tracking. And as you can see, if I turn my head smoothly, it slows down in the middle and almost stops. Now, this might seem like an odd way of doing it at first, but once you get used to using a dead zone, you'll find that it gives you a much smoother sense of control of head tracking in the game. And remember, you can set a dead zone for any axes in any way you like. This really is a highly customizable tracking experience. So getting used to the idea of setting dead zones for different axes is the best way to go about making sure you get the best possible experience with your TrackHat Sensor V2. Up next, let's talk about mapping limits. So there are going to be some simulators and some games where moving your head too far is actually going to be an uncomfortable thing to do, and you're not really going to get anything from viewing that much of an angle or that far away from your default viewpoint. So in order to regulate that, you can set a mapping limit. So I'm back in the Your window for the mapping properties here. And if I was to take that top point and drag it down, you can see that the line after it remains flat. This means that if I turn my head to a certain degree, as you see as I go past that point, tracking stops being output. So if I go back into the flight simulator, unpause head tracking, and then turn my head to the left, it stops at a hard point right there, and the other way as well. Now, using this method will allow you to create a much more comfortable experience if you're using something like a fighter jet where there's nothing really behind you that you need to see, or you need to be able to always make sure your head goes back to a central point. Setting those limits to your mapping means that head tracking will be much more comfortable and reliable in your experience. Okay, up next, let's talk about filtering. Now, filtering is the way that the machine learning code within the TrackHat Sensor V2 adjusts to the movement of your head. Generally speaking, TrackHat OpenTrack opts for a slightly smoother and less responsive head tracking experience. But if you want to change that setting for yourself and experiment with it, if you open the options page and head to the last tab, the filter tab, you can adjust the smoothing amount here. Now, currently I have mine set to about 1 degree of smoothing, and in the simulator that looks a little bit like this. Quite sharp, quite responsive, and quite fast. Now, if I hop back into TrackHat OpenTrack and increase that setting to about 2, and then I'm back into the simulator, it's a much, much smoother feeling now. It's a bit slower and everything's a bit more relaxed. Setting this number exactly the way you like means that you'll get better comfort in longer playtime. So if you're doing long-haul airline simulations, you're going to want to set a higher smoothing experience just to give your head a bit of a break and to let your eyes get used to the natural movement of head tracking. Okay. The last thing to know in this quick start guide is about saving profiles. Once you've been using TrackHat OpenTrack for a little while, you definitely need to save your profile to make sure that all the settings are the same next time you come back to it. Now, these settings will be saved as you change them, but what we highly recommend you do is that you change the settings based on the aircraft or the simulator that you're using, so you can get used to and get comfortable to each one. In order to save your profile, just click Stop Head Tracking, click the drop-down menu next to the profile window, and create new copied config. You can then name it anything you like, and that profile will be saved. You can then create other configs based off of this one in order to get the best possible experience in other aircraft in the same simulator. Now remember, it does take time to configure head tracking to exactly how you need. Be patient and be prepared to try new things and mess around with settings a little bit. You can always click here and click the default config to come back to TrackHat's default settings and start configuring again. All right, thanks for watching this super quick guide on getting started with the head tracking with the TrackHat Sensor V2 in Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. Don't forget, we're always available for support on our website if you need more assistance in getting head tracking tuned to your liking. See you around.